Okay. Let me do a quick clap test.
All right, y'all. So, Claude Robinson here. I am doing a quick camera test to see the settings between the Blackmagic Pocket. Did it already. The settings between the Blackmagic Cinema Camera 6K full frame and the Sony A7S3. So, a little bit of specifications on the camera. The A7S3, which I'm currently looking at right now, is in 4K, 23.976 frames per second, versus the Blackmagic, which I'm currently looking at now, is in true 24 frames per second, which I'd rather shoot in if I'd personally have a preference. They both have the same Kelvin, which is 5600, balance for daylight. There's no other light that's coming in here temperature wise other than the sun and the daylight, so I balance both of the cameras at 5600. The Blackmagic has the built-in OLPF that is supposed to reduce like moiré and artifacts and reduce all this stuff a better color balance on your skin tone, so hopefully that's true at this current point. Again, I am shooting on the Sigma 24-70 2.8 on both lenses, so right now this is the Blackmagic at the 24mm and this is the Sony A7S3 at 24mm. I'm going to punch into the different focal lengths and see how they just look on camera, just as a comparison. Again, right now we are 24mm. The cameras are both set to f-stop of 4.0, so that's what the aperture is at on both cameras, A7S3 or 4.0. The Blackmagic is at 4.0. They're both at their native ISO, so the Blackmagic is at 400 ISO, and then the A7S3 is at 640, just at their base, just to see what dynamic range tests are capable of. A7S3 obviously has all these features: image stabilization, autofocus, high dynamic range, great and low light. So many great things that I love about the A7S3, and I can't speak on it enough. But with the Blackmagic, image quality to me is just far superior, especially with its price point. So that's that. Again, I'm going to switch to the different focal lengths and we're going to check them out. So, this is 24mm, let's check out 35. So this is 35mm that I'm currently at for both the Blackmagic Cinema Camera 6K full frame. I can't believe I just got that on the first try, second, third, or fourth try, but first try for this. And this is the Sony A7S3. So on the back of the camera, I must say that the A7S3 feels like it's far superior as far as the dynamic range for whatever reason. We'll see what the tests look like when I get them into DaVinci Resolve. Again, I'm just a huge fanboy of the Blackmagic Cinema Camera 6K full frame and the image quality. So we'll see how it all holds up. But this is at 35mm. Again, this is at f-stop 4.0. Haven't done anything as far as change the settings. Everything's still at 5600. I keep looking at the Blackmagic because I just love it, but everything's at 5600. Alright, so this is at 50mm. I don't know what the frame looks like. I could be cut off, my head could be cut off, and I don't necessarily know. Right now, I'm just kind of going with the test of how things are going. In a perfect world, I'm in frame, I'm in focus. And apparently, I heard that the 24-70, I don't know if it's on the E mount, but apparently the L mount is parfocal. So I haven't changed the focus, not once, this whole time. I've just been on this mark. So we'll see if it's part focal, and I've been in frame the whole, I've been in focus the whole time. Again, this is at 50mm. None of the settings have changed. Still f-stop 4.0, 640 base ISO on the Sony A7S3, and 640 base, 400 base ISO on the full frame. Okay, last but not least, this is 70mm. I'm currently looking at the A7S3, and again, the dynamic range, I don't know, is just looking far superior. Maybe it's because I have the LUT on, and we'll see, but it just looks for whatever better, and it's making me upset. While at the same time making me happy, because I'm a huge Sony fanboy, so appreciate you, Sony. Blackmagic full frame, both cameras again are at 70 millimeters, and both cameras again are using the Sigma 24-70 art lens, the DGDN art lens. Again, they're both at f4, both at their base ISOs, both at the same Kelvin temperature. Just wanted to see the test and how everything goes. Again, at this, there's speculation that the 24-70 L mount, I don't know if the E mount is parfocal, but it doesn't really matter because the A7S3 is autofocus, so it doesn't really matter. But with the L mount, I've heard that it's parfocal. I haven't changed the focus once. I've just been hitting this same exact mark. So we'll see. I'm going to do these tests. Thank you for watching. Like, comment, subscribe if you like these type of videos and you want me to do any type of other tests with Sony versus Blackmagic, or any other lenses that I can think of that I can try to get my hands on. Thank you for watching.